Adding real-time interactions in your app is a great way to enhance your user's experience. Today in this video, we're going to take a look at how you can add live cursor position sharing feature using Flutter and Supabase. We'll be taking a look at the custom painters API of Flutter, as well as Supabase's broadcast feature. Let's dive in. So I have a blank Flutter app here, and we're going to start up by creating a blank CSS widget. We can call it canvas page. Pass the canvas page to the material app, and we are going to replace the default placeholder with a blank scaffold. Now, before we dive into the UI stuff, let's create our data model. We can call it UserCursor, and it represents a single cursor in the app. It has a few properties like position or color. Now we can define the FromJSON constructor. It takes a map of string of dynamic, and it'll populate the properties of UserCursor object. To get the position of the object, we're just going to say that the position is stored within the position argument of the JSON, and the x coordinate can be accessed with x, and then y coordinate can be accessed with y. Now on to color, and we're going to do something unique here. So we're going to create an extension method of the color class called randomColor up here. This extension method is going to have a single static method called getRandomFromID. It'll take a single parameter ID, and based on the ID, it'll return a random color. The actual code itself of how I'm generating a unique color from the given ID isn't that important or exciting, but the important idea here is that we have a random ID for every user, and then we are generating a color that matches that ID. Now let's add the ID property that I forgot about earlier. This will be a UUID representing a unique ID for each user. And now that we have an ID, we can generate a random color from the ID. And we can also extract the ID from JSON and assign it to ID property. And now that we are done with the FromJSON constructor, we can move on to the toJSON method. Essentially, this is just the reverse process of the FromJSON method. For ID, we're just going to pass ID. For position, it's going to be a map of x of position dx and then y of position dy. And because color property is going to be generated from the ID property, we don't need to include it here. I'm just going to close the user cursor as we're done with it, and now we can define some states for the canvas page state. Now we can create a user cursor's property here, which is going to be type of map of string of user cursor. The key of this map will be the UUID assigned to each user. And finally, the fun begins. We get to play with the custom paint widget. Of the custom paint widget, we want to take up the entire size of variable, so we're just going to pass the media query.of.size. And then we can also pass a painter parameter. We are going to call it canvas painter, and we're going to define it up here. So it's going to be class of canvas painter, which extends the custom painter. It'll have a single property called UserCursors, which matches the state that we had with the canvas page state. Let's also add the two override methods that's required by CustomPainter. Starting with shouldRepaint, in this case, every single time the property changes, we want to repaint the canvas, so we're just going to return true. Now onto the paint method. Here we want to basically draw each cursors on the position they are located at. We're going to start up by looping through each cursor and getting the position. Once we have the position, we can get started with drawing the path. For the second argument, paint, we're just going to assign the cursor color. For the path itself, we're going to start out with the path instance and move to the position of the cursors. From here, we're basically going to draw a line a few times to complete the shape of a cursor. We'll be calling line 2 a few times. I'm just going to add the position dx and dy and copy it a few times. Then I hopped on Figma and got the list of coordinates to draw a cursor. Okay, I think our custom painter is ready to go. Let's go back to our custom paint widget and pass the user cursors property. Now at this point, we can try to see if we can actually see the cursors being painted on the canvas. So let's create a static dummy data here, give it an empty string of ID, some color, and a position. We can just say both X and Y's are 100. Run the app in debug mode, and we see a nice cursor shown on our app. Great, let's delete this demo data. Now at this point, we can get into the actual logic of syncing the cursor positions with other users. And for that, we're going to be using a few libraries. First, Supabase Flutter for the real-time engine. And second, UUID just to generate a unique identifier. Now coming back to the Dart code. Let's add another property here, and let's call it MyID. This will be my unique ID. We also need a real-time channel instance. We can call this canvas channel. we'll be using this canvas channel instance to interact with Supabase real-time. Let's initialize these variables within the init state. My ID will be a v4uuid. And then canvas channel is going to be Supabase channel, but we haven't initialized Supabase yet, so let's go up here and initialize Supabase. Hit to database.new and create your Supabase project, then copy and paste your Supabase URL and anon key. I'm also just going to create a global Supabase variable right here. Now the canvas channel is going to be Supabase.channel, and we can give it a channel name of canvas, and then on broadcast. The event name can also be any string, we're just going to call that canvas as well, and then let's fill in the callback. First, we are going to construct the UserCursor object from the JSON payload. Then we can update the local state, passing the cursor.id as the key and then cursor as the value. And then we can wrap all this inside a set state. Remember to add subscribe at the end, and we are ready to listen to other people's cursor positions. We can also dispose the Supabase channel in the dispose method. Now at this point, we can broadcast our cursor positions to other users that are also viewing the app at the same time. For that, we wrap the entire custom pane widget with a mouse region. Mouse region allows us to track where the cursor is within the widget. We can extract the cursor position from the onHover callback. And for the color should be automatically generated from the ID, so let's actually modify the constructor. And now that we have modified the constructor, we don't need the color parameter, and then we can broadcast this MyCursor object through Supabase Broadcast. Payload is going to be cursor, and then we are going to pass the JSON representation of the MyCursor. And that's it! Now when the user moves their cursors within the region, that information is being broadcasted to other users through Supabase Realtime. Let's see if it works! I'm using Google Chrome and Safari here because opening two Chrome windows had some issues with the mouse region widget, but it looks like it's working great. We can make the cursors move smoothly by cranking up the events per second. So we can edit the real-time options, and events per second we can assign it 30. By default it's 10. And refresh the page, and see the cursors look a lot smoother now. And that's how you can add live cursor position sharing feature in your app. Working with custom painters is always so much fun, isn't it? And we'll be adding more features on top of what we worked on today in the coming episodes so that we can build a Figma clone. If you don't want to miss any of that, hit that subscribe button and get notified. Until then, bye!